that we look at life from God's perspective. And when we look at life from God's perspective, things are not as bad as they may appear. Amen, somebody. The responsibility thrusted upon Joseph in this narrative is an awesome example of why the correlation between God's perspective and our obedience is so important. You see, Joseph could not mentally or emotionally manage the thought of being embarrassed that people talk about him behind his back. He could not handle the personal rejection or the risk of losing significant relationships, including his own family. This was not the way Joseph imagined his life. And I feel Joseph this morning, because I too know what it feels like to suffer in silence and to wonder, how in the world did I get here? To be in a room full of people and yet convince myself that there is no one I can talk to. And the people around me have no idea that I am suffering inside. Man, I wish I had just a little more time to talk about what it feels like to suffer in silence. It is a dangerous place when you suffer in silence, because it is in those times we are tempted to secretly make decisions outside of God's will, because we can't handle his silence. It was not in God's will for Joseph to divorce Mary in silence, or in secret rather, or to make her a public display. Had he done so, he would have missed out on the biggest blessing known to man. He would have missed out on a blessing so great it would change time and circumstances as we know it. But because of his self-denial and because of his obedience to God, he would be blessed beyond his wildest imagination. He was blessed with the responsibility of rearing the Son of the living God. There are times in our life when God blesses us beyond our ability to understand what God is doing. But the Bible says that eyes have not seen and ears have not heard, neither has it entered into the heart of man the great things that God has for you and I. Sometimes, in order for God to get us to see life from his perspective, he has to send us a messenger. And this is why I come to church, and I love it. I have gotten to the point in my spiritual walk where I know that there are times in my life when I am not looking at my situation from God's perspective. And I need to make my way into the house of the Lord so I can hear a word from his messenger so we can adjust my lens. There are times in my life when I need to look at life through a different set of glasses. Do I have a witness this morning? Is there anyone in here that knows that when you come into this house, it's not for form, it's not for fashion, it's not to show off in front of the world, but it's because you can see me a word from God? The angel of the Lord came to Joseph. Refocused his vision, enlightened him to God's perspective, and changed his plans overnight. Has God ever changed your plans? Have you ever been self-engaged in a long deliberation over a particular challenge or situation that's wrecking havoc in your life? And after careful consideration, you finally come to the conclusion that the plan you have decided on is a rock-solid plan, your mind is made up, and then God steps in and says no. Somebody in this morning, God will not say no to your plan and not give you an alternative. Hold on, let me say that again. You've got to catch that. God will not say no to your plan and not give you an alternative strategy as a replacement. In his word, it tells us that he has a plan and purpose for our life, a plan to prosper you, a plan to give you hope in the future. It also says that many are the plans of a man's heart, but it is God's purpose that prevails. Joseph is showing us through the lens of this text how important obedience is when it comes to obeying God. See, when we are obedient to God, we then step out of God's way and accept what God has for us. He is an all-powerful God. He is all-knowing, and he does not serve us. We serve him. It is important as believers that we remember the fact that what God has for us, it is for us. You can never underestimate God. You and I may think we know what is best for our lives, but God knows what's best. You and I cannot outsmart God. Let me help somebody out this morning. No matter how smart you are, no matter how much money you have, no matter how many degrees you have acquired, or how many accomplishments you have achieved, there is nothing that you can possibly produce that is greater for your good than what God has for you. I don't know what to do this disobedient and become discouraged. But now is the time for you to accept what God has for you. Because God knows what's best. How many of us know that there are times when God will not always give you what you want, but He surely will give you what you need when you need it?